In this session, we will start up Coolselector and set it for industrial refrigeration solutions. After this video, you will know how to modify options to filter out the components, edit preferences. You will see an example of a selection for a project and several sub-projects. You will learn how to generate a report. Coolselector shows all components by default. Let's see how to select only the components relevant to industrial refrigeration. Let's select Options and go to Preferences. As you see, All Components is highlighted. Once we select Industrial Components, Commercial Components will disappear. We can also return to Preferences and select Edit Preferences. This opens a window that shows the details behind industrial refrigeration options. In the General tab, the default system selected is shown to be a pump separating system. We want to calculate on valves and line components and components in series. We also want to see performance curve and performance details. If there are specific products that we do not want to see, we can deselect them. For example, we do not want to use filter dryers, so let's deselect these. We can also see all connections. If it's assumed for this example that I am in Europe, I do not need to see ANSI connection, so I'll remove all the ANSI connections away. And I don't want any ANSI pipes either. So now we have our preferences. Let's look at operation conditions shown every time we start up the program with a new project. We want to start with ammonia, which fits our purpose well. We want to show a capacity of 100 kilowatts. And the operation temperature is minus 10 and plus 30, circulating rate of 3, pump pressure 2 bar. All this data can be saved. We click OK. We're asked, do I want to change it? Click Yes. And now we can make some modifications. We have taken away some products, so we need to save it under a different name. Let's call it Industrial Refrigeration Test. Click OK. If we look at Preferences, here is our Industrial Refrigeration Test. So now we have specified preferences in the program exactly as we want them to be. Every time we start a new project by default. But we can also open a project saved earlier. Let's create a new project. Let's click No. Let's select a component. We want a stop valve. As you see, this is pump separating system, a wet return line, so we choose that one. We need to specify operation condition. Let's input 150 kilowatts, temperatures of minus 10 and plus 30, and a circulating rate of 3. And in this case, Coolselector suggests that we select the component based on velocity, here of 12 meters per second. We go for an angle valve, and here we have SVA 65, 12.55 meters per second, and then we can see the pressure drop. This is the operation point that we have. If this is okay, we can just keep it as it is, and generate a report where we can find everything documented. We can also return and analyze what the benefit will be if we choose an SVA 80. Then we can see the velocity goes down. We can see that the pressure drops. If this is the valve we want to have, then we could add a new one to this project. What we will do is, when we have a certain selection, we add a new sub-project and, if we want, we can have a solenoid valve here. We will still be in the wet return line. Here is the wet return line and the solenoid valve. Here it is important to select solenoid valve that has small pressure drop and we can choose ICLX, which is a two-step solenoid which is hot gas operated. So let's take that one. Let's take the third product. We can take the control valve. Let's input this to the return line and select this one. Coolselector suggests a solution based on pressure drop. And that's the reason why we have to create a pressure drop and we have servo-operated valve. In this example, servo-operated valve can work up to 0.2 bar. So we need to select the valve that can do the job. If we now look at the curve, we can see that the curve is different from the other ones. Here we have the opening curve of the valve. In the yellow area, the valve is partly open. In the white area, it is fully open. And when we go down here at low capacity, we turn into the red area. We can see the text is changing to red. This is where the valve is just a little bit open, and we don't want to open our valve in this area. We can once again choose different sizes. Let's keep the one the program suggests. The report can be generated again, though this time also showing sub-projects. There are three different sub-projects. We can then choose to print all of them, or we can select some of them. Let's take the last one. Once updated, it will generate everything we need. This concludes the tutorial on how to start up Coolselector and set the preferences for industrial refrigeration. Stay tuned for other tutorials.